Thank you. seems our fates are joined.
Yeah. battle. Greninja. Sora.
Yeah. hope. We hit right.
Begins with a strong base.
Arc Thunder!
Hey!
Arc Fire!
Game!
3 steps ahead.
Thank you.
battle, Diddy Kong! Thank you.
Thunder! our fates are joined. Thunder! Freeze! Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to Xeno291, or just welcome if you've been here watching the quad stream, as we have quite a few hot sets going on right now. We've got Mega versus Helper right now, if we want to take a look at that, because that is one of our bracket qualifier matches.
I think we should, and you know, it's not often that you see Sora here being played at such a top level.
Yeah, I mean, Helper has definitely been shown up a lot more as of late. Right now, taking Mega to his last stock. I think this is still game one right now. There are the players. They're playing the video game.
Listen, we're having a good time seeing Helper with his glasses. That is a rare Helper glasses moment. If we can zoom in on that, see those UV-blocking glasses? He's got that, like, it's sitting, like, on the bridge of his nose.
There we go. All right, so, yep, still sitting here at last stock. I'm pretty sure game one, relatively even percentages right now. Helper right now being the one to push the advantage.
And just cycling through all those spells, Spyraga, Thundaga. Ooh. Oh, saving that Thundaga for offstage, obviously. That's really where it shines.
Ooh, and the Sonic Blade catching Mega, getting a little bit aggressive there at the ledge, especially when Helper's at the wheel. Kind of got to be careful with the aggression. He is known to make his home at the ledge and just throw all of the hitboxes to swat you away.
I feel like Mega knows when to, like, weave in and out. Like, Helper was using that, just holding that forward smash, waiting for him to be aggressive, and Mega's like, all right, I need to slow it down.
Yeah. Ooh, the spot dodge on the grab and the up air, not going to be taking it just yet.
Aim, why did you lie to us? That's the kill screen and everything.
That
all
should
right.
definitely be taking it. Dash attack.
At ledge even? Oh, no.
Absolutely. Actually, if we want to, just kidding, I was going to say take a look at Devin versus Goku fan, because that looked like it was about to end. I'm like 80% sure. That's a stage hazard tag, right?
Yes.
That definitely sounds like a stage hazard tag.
Which one? The re?
No, Goku fan.
Yes, that
Goku is. Goku fan 0318. Definitely one of Stage Hazard's better tags, I'll say.
Stage Hazard is a menace. I played him in bracket. I was like, on a scale of 1 to Mishka, how good are you as a Samus? And he's like, I taught that boy. So I better be above Mishka.
All right. Anyway, we've got Mega and Helper game 2. Helper running it right back to Small Battlefield, trying to find his way off of the ledge right there. Once again, using the up B to get Mega off of him.
I like the Battle of Nairs here, while...
That F-tilt is worth $5.99. Did you see how far back it hit Mega back off stage? But unfortunately, Helper dropping the edge guard.
Yeah, close to the blast zone, but not quite. Ooh. But that up smash is going to take it.
Dash attack very minus on shield. Helper got some nice charge on that one, too, securing that kill.
Only good off stage. Uh-oh. All right, what are we going to see for an edge guard?
I go looking for that down air, trying to end things, waiting for the upbeat, but still, unfortunately, not quite able to find the edge guard of his dreams. And instead, Helper just making himself at home off stage.
Helper playing very defensively here off stage, looking like John Numbers here. Yeah. All he needs is a soccer ball.
Sora does not need more projectiles to use at the ledge. No, thank you.
You're right. I'm sorry. The fireball is already like a soccer ball.
Soccer ball, Aga.
It's already an item. You know that the soccer ball that turns off flames.
I would trade header for Fire Aga.
Oh my god.
But only Fire Aga.
Only? No. You gotta take the whole enchilada. There
we go. Fine. You know, I would trade header for magic.
Okay.
That's just the name of the special. It's just called magic.
We fit wizard.
But Helper right now really running away with this game too. Catching Mega getting a little bit impatient at the ledge. Once again, it's been all whiff punishes.
Where did
this game
go?
Two.
Oh my
They're
goodness.
They're gone. Okay, but.
Just like that shield, almost gone.
Yeah, the aggression kind of starting to work out for Mega if he can get that shield down. But all this time off stage.
Oh
no.
You
the
didn't
Sora,
recover?
At the Sora? SD.
HO3K, help me.
The Helper Classic giving away stocks.
He's helping him out.
Ooh, it's definitely kind of looking like Mega needs all the help he can get. 85% on last stock here on this game, too. Helper on a clean, untouched second stock. Finally, though.
Why did you say that?
Well, setting him back up off stage, but same old song and dance, really.
Hey, Mega looking for this Mega kill. Oh, no.
Yep, getting caught by the Sonic Blade. Mega has just not been able to find his rhythm while Helper is in stage, quote-unquote, stage disadvantage.
No, no.
What are we doing, Helper?
Oh, we're up smashing. That jump.
And that is a pretty commanding game two from Helper after a pretty even game one.
Honestly, I was thinking Mega was going to bring that back because obviously Sora has to do all that work. But really, an Ike, all he needs is like two hits. Speaking of two hits, Yoshi here. Motomoto going against Astor.
What?
AstorMD coming out strong. I think this is the third Xeno in a row that he's actually come out as a Zero suit. Love to see the representation.
Absolutely. Definitely not a character we see at Xeno very often. But right now, Aster is making it work here against Motomoto here in Losers Round 2. Winner of this going to be moving on to fight Devin for the top 12.
Oh. If you beat Production, are you just booted out of the tournament?
Production is not a TO.
All right. Well, still.
True. Devin does not have the authority.
They just if they beat Helper, they're DQ'd.
you heard it right here, folks. Mega, you got to lose your next match. Sorry.
You take a dive in game three. All right, Motomoto starting to get some percentage on the board against Aster. Nice down B to reverse the situation, get himself back onto the stage. But this ledge pressure from Aster is doing wonders right now.
That up smash is just lingering so long to catch that jump. Even Super Armor isn't going to save him.
All right, quick Zare dash attack confirm. Get a little bit of percent on the board. A little bit of extra credit. That up tilt can be so huge against Yoshi. Such a great up anti-air.
All right, so far missing all these Zares.
Ooh, tried to chase the air dodge, but unfortunately Motomoto a little bit too slow, and instead might be finding his fate here at the ledge.
I think that is the disadvantage that Yoshi has here. He's a bit of a big target for this tether grab. Oh,
ooh, all right,
speaking
though.
Of target, that head big enough to land 2LB into the blast zone.
Yep, the up special almost doing it, the boost kick. Trying to keep this aerial pressure, but Motomoto still fighting. Does still have the jump, able to make it past that plasma whip on the way back.
Oh, what a spike. Not even a spike.
Yep, the Nair into flip kick going to be doing it. Anyway, coming back into game three, Mega actually being up a stock against Helper after that insanely dominant game two.
Mega just a couple hits away from being DQ'd in this bracket.
Yeah, finally starting, finally starting to find that rhythm there at the ledge. Helper not able to get those whiff punishes that we saw in game two.
All right, looking for a down air just to... Oh my gosh!
Back off!
Oh, showing off. Who's got a better counter for once? Mega taking it over Helper 2-1.
Yep, that's going to be Mega moving on to top 12 winner side. It is top 12 in the bracket. Kind of a small Xeno this week, only 25 entrants.
So I was told by Makemake that the reason that it's so small this week is because everybody has finals.
Oh,
I hope
yeah.
That's the case.
Yeah, so they have finals. They have final exams, final papers. So
yeah,
everyone just realized like all their papers are due Friday. And so they're like, ah.
I forgot.
You forgot how young the crowd is? I got a job. I got an apartment. I don't have roommates. I don't need to worry about school. I need to worry about rent.
Ugh. Oh, God, don't talk to me about rent right now. No end.
Oh, that's right.
Thank
I'm so
you.
Sorry. You had a bit of a nightmare with that. I'm sorry to bring up bad memories here.
It's all right. We've still got a couple matches here left in Wave B, such as Girl Scout Cookies versus Admirad.
Oh, I want to see this. All right, so Girl Scout Cookies. Girl Scout Cookies is the youngling. Admirad over there with the Joker. So if he was a Girl Scout Cookie, what Girl Scout Cookie would he be?
I'm gonna be honest. I'm a fan of the Samoas.
Ooh, Samoas are good.
Those are good. I think those are underrated in the Girl Scout cookie library.
What's the lemon one? Like the lemon shortbread?
I know what you're talking about. I have no idea what the name of it is.
Oh, right? It's just the lemon bread.
Yeah, the lemon one.
The lemon one. But the shortbread cookies are also pretty good. Have that with a little coffee and oh.
Lemon so flavor is the best flavor.
There we go. We agree on it.
Of anything, not just cookies.
Anything? Lemon meringue pie?
True.
I'll just stick with lemon pie. I'm not a big fan of the meringue.
Hmm, the lemon pie is still good.
Lemon pie is literally just lemon sugar eggs. Put it in a pie tin.
Right now, though, Girl Scout cookies showing off that they are the best cookie in the library right now.
The library, in the venue. Go ask them if you want to buy some Girl Scout cookies. It's out of season, but they have some in the freezer.
This is real commentary right now.
Listen.
Listen. Listen to our commentary. Tell us we're good.
All right, bomb recovery going to be coming through.
Oh.
Waiting out the counter as well, but unfortunately waited just a little bit too long.
That's a nice extra credit there, 88%.
Yep, and as well, our Sen is going to be gone.
It's a ledge trap there.
Yeah,
forcing Admirat to roll in.
Yeah, I love the placement of the bomb from Girl Scout Cookies. Ooh, catching the ledge hang at that high percentage. You cannot be getting too comfortable at that ledge. The bomb explosion is coming.
All right, only being able to throw out one at a time, but those fire arrows are going to just pop Admiran up. No conversion, though, still living at 174. And
right
Big
now.
Brother has come out to play, but nope, that down air, taking that stonk.
Yeah, one of Youngling's kind of few raw kill moves. Usually, Youngling does like to rely on the confirms. Great jab lock from Admirad. Ooh, and the Rebel's Guard coming out once again. Not a true combo from Girl Scout Cookies.
Ooh, oatmeal cookies. Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
I'm not sure if Girl Scout Cookies include those, though.
No, unfortunately not. I'm sorry. Is there one downside? Wow, managed to actually suck him into the up special? Whoa.
Yeah, that move is crazy with the vacuum.
And I know that oatmeal raisin is like a popular one, but oatmeal chocolate chip is the king.
What about just straight up oatmeal?
Really? Oatmeal's good, too. But oatmeal chocolate chip.
All right, if you guys want to send us some cookies, be sure to follow us on Twitch, YouTube, and the Twitter once we get that back.
Follow us on Blue Sky.
You got an invite?
No.
I want to send some skeets.
I am so glad that it seems like Blue Sky is finally starting to enter like the public consciousness. Like people are talking about it, and I'm just like, oh, man. Because that's the thing. We were waiting for...
Oh, my God, it dropped out.
We were waiting for a Twitter alternative, but it has to be in the public consciousness to actually work.
Right.
And now people are talking about it, so hopefully it actually sticks.
Shout outs to Drill.
Thanks, Drill, whoever you are.
Oh, he's known. He actually got doxxed, and we all just remembered to just forget. You know, be nice to our favorite internet host. And oh my gosh, that was definitely Girl Scout Cookie's favorite game. As they take it over Admirad 2-0.
All right. So another match. Let's see. Fawn versus Haze.
Yeah, let's check out Fawn versus Haze. Another winner's side bracket qualifier match. Haze having just taken things over Mishka. That was definitely a hot set. I was checking that out on the quad stream. But going from Mishka to Fawn, in terms of like a zoner player matchup, No shade to Mishka at all, but going from Mishka to Fawn is like going from hard mode to lunatic mode.
Right. Mishka loves the burst options and uses the projectiles of pressure, but Fawn is all projectiles, and the pressure never lets up.
And as well, just so proficient with Duck Hunt, being able to convert off of so many of those stray hits, always having like can setups in mind, always having the goons out, having the clay pigeon setups, like right there, just that one little conversion from the clay pigeon into the grab, giving Fawn so much like stage advantage.
Okay, great monkey flip. Woo.
Yep, that flip kick just going right through all of the Duck Hunt projectiles.
Funny little interaction there with the banana and the can. Both really just canceling each other out in the air. Okay, that may be enough to kill. No.
No, not quite. Even on town and city. All right, just giving the can a little slap, trying to get it out of Fawn's hands.
Ace has been doing such a great job of just like stalling that can in the air with the banana.
Not
really
the
using
death cry.
It's the best one.
It's so good.
It's what I've wanted to hear ever since I played Duck Hunt on the NES. Now it's my turn to laugh.
No. Stream took a dark turn.
And look, I was really bad at shooting things on the screen, okay? I got very familiar with that dog's laugh.
Why doesn't he have the NES laugh in this game?
It would have been awesome.
All right, Fawn just trying to set up this, like, full screen pressure with the... That poor Bandito
no!
is getting taken for a ride, and Haze is the one getting taken for a ride off the top of the screen. That is going to be Fawn taking game one.
Okay, so Town and City. Really, that was game one on Town and City?
I feel very inclined to show something that I noticed.
Yes? What do we get?
Once I get the... Reset that video.
All right, monkey flip.
All
okay.
Right. I want you to watch very carefully.
Oh.
Watch that gunman. Ooh.
Yeah, he gets taken.
Ooh. 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 Ooh.
Aww. Ooh. Honestly, he just went all the way to the other side.
He got smoked.
He got infinited.
Poor guy.
He got smoked.
Okay, Kalos, I think this is a great counter pick for Diddy. What do you think?
I definitely think it's a pretty good counter pick for Diddy. The side walls definitely great for Diddy's recovery, as well as making Z-drop banana into down air a lot more accessible, and as well just the flat, like the main platform being flat is gonna give Haze some more options in approaching Fawn's like zoning options.
However, Haze is just having a hard time getting down here.
Yeah, platform or not, that can is still aerial, and it's gonna be finding you up there.
The floor might as well be lava. He gets in just to be popped back right up.
Fighting Duck Hunt can be very difficult. You need a lot of knowledge to fight this character. As someone who's fought Fawn 80 gajillion times at this point, win or lose, it's a lot less about the character that you're using and more about how well you know all of the tools that Duck Hunt has, because there's 50,000 interactions for all three of those projectiles. And if you don't know him, then it's just going to seem like there's never a safe time to mosey on in and attack Duck Hunt. But there are gaps. You just have to know when, like the properties of the gunman, the properties of the can, when it's like hit by a projectile or a physical attack or the ping, the clay pigeon, how it can hit everyone if you hit it for some reason, things like that. How much lag there is on clay pigeon? Jesus Christ. There's so many things to keep in mind. Fuck.
Not mad. Not mad at all.
Ooh, but right now, Haze just having so much trouble trying to find his way in right now. That can just putting a wrench in so many of his plans. The gunman as well, keeping him locked down. That was the slowest gunman, the kind of lanky one. But finally, though, the up tilt going to be putting Haze on the board. But 120%, not really looking too good right now. Gotta be careful of that can. Actually gets caught by the zapper hitbox as well. Very unfortunate.
Uh-oh. Actually, the Duck Hunt community calls it the pings.
The pings?
The pings? Pings? Oh, I get it. Ping, 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 ping.
I guess.
Who told you this? This feels like a troll.
I hear Fawn just call it that casually when she's talking about Duck Hunt things.
I suppose she is the community.
Yeah.
Who else plays
All
the character?
One player.
I am dictating the meta now.
All right, using that gunman to find yourself some space, and now putting Haze back in the corner. Not able to find the second conversion there. But also, like, in addition to like the three projectiles that Duck Hunt has at their disposal,
well, Fawn, four if they catch the banana.
Yeah, I was gonna say Fawn has also just been playing around the banana so well, just adding another layer to the madness that is Duck Hunt projectiles.
All right, monkey flip for his mobility, throwing that banana in their face.
It's really good when all three of your projectiles block a banana.
One versus three projectiles, who wins? Uh-oh.
Oh, can coming out.
Get
off
right
of me.
And I recently learned this. Duck Hunt's Nair is active for 35 frames.
That's really funny.
That is forever. You saw that?
See?
Yes. He just cartwheeled his way over there.
You can just let it rip. And it'll still hit you.
Ah, that dash attack not connecting, though. Haze gets to live just a little bit longer.
He's having to play so safe around this can, as well as the gunman.
Don't get hit.
That
it's a bullet hell.
Standing there with his pants down for so long, and he still blocked the banana. Can is coming.
Yep. And that is the second game that can takes it. Not up in the air, but off the side this time.
Yep, and that is going to be Fawn moving on to top 12 in a fairly dominant 2-0.
Looks like we've already started.
Yes, I believe we will be starting momentarily.
Oh, yeah. No. I was just looking at losers round three over there. Mishka and Girl Scout Cookies.
Yep, I believe our last Wave B game of the night.
Yeah, let me pull that up. Also, since you brought it up, if you, for the two tall gunmen, you can kind of put them into a special surprised mode, where for the black-suited one, you can knock his hat off, and the white one, you can pull his pants down.
Oh.
If you do that, they stay on the screen a lot longer than they're normally supposed to.
I mean, that's actually pretty clever.
It can be good, because it removes Duck Hunt's ability to pull a new one.
But it also, like, blocks a lot of projectiles, so, you know.
Yeah, it also puts, like, a permanent meat shield on the stage.
Exactly. That's all they are to you, meat shields. All right, Mishka just barely down in percentage for the stock.
Yep,
projectile trying. Player versus projectile player. Looking like the Wi-Fi special over here. Who do you not want to play on Elite Smash? These two characters.
Between the two, maybe the Samus a little bit more.
I'll play the Samus over the Toon Link.
All right. Regardless of who wins this, we're going to regular stream after this game.
Okay.
All right. Sounds good.
Okie dokie.
So if Girl Scout Cookies wins this, we're just not going to know
it's
how this set
be,
ends.
We'll let you know, chat. You don't
we're not
have
telling.
To pay attention.
We're not telling
no!
you.
No! Misha going too God. Low. Even stocks apiece. We'll see if this was in their advantage, though.
Ooh, whipping the up B, now putting Girl Scout Cookies off stage. This is where Mishka really loves to set up all these Samus bombs.
All right, the Hero Time, they're doing a good job of just going through those bombs. If they can save Hyrule, they can defeat Samus.
Ooh, all right, great weight on the air dodge there from Girl Scout Cookies. Keeping Mishka uncomfortable here on these platforms, really trying to make sure that Mishka can't really get too much charge on this charge shot. Ooh, the boomerang
what?
Just blocking the charge shot. It was not fully charged.
Technology versus wood. Who wins?
That's a special Kokiri boomerang.
Ah, that's right. L technology. Uh-oh.
All right, Girl Scout Cookies using that double jump to make their way back onto stage, but hasn't really found a meaningful hit in a while.
Oh,
Screw
no, that's never safe.
Should be doing it. Now it's going to be Mishka moving on into top 12, and as well, we are going to be moving into top 12 as we move on into bracket.
Everyone's moving into top 12.
All of us.
Hey.
We did it.
Hey.
We made it into top 12.
Hey.
Thanks for solid
job.
Mishka
Let's
be
go,
fishing. Google. Okay. So let's just wait a few moments, and then we can get started.
All right. I think you pulled up bracket faster than me.
I've done it.
I mean, I'm going to do
it
now-ish.
Oh, we're going for an ad?
We do not have the tablet for ads.
Yeah, where is it? So where's the stream kits? Oh.
I don't know. It's lost in the void somewhere.
That's all right. Oh.
I tried refreshing it earlier.
Is it just down, or is it just the wrong IP? Ping Devin.
Who knows?
Aw, shucks. And he didn't bring us any? Unbelievable. Oh, it looks like a... Oh. I was about to say, they're going Steve?
No. Okay. No, they're just messing around. In the,
okay, okay. Because I have seen Kazuya Mishima from Fawn before, and I'm like, all right, this is a serious match.
We've seen every character from Fawn at this point. I saw Fawn playing Ridley in pools.
Ridley is good. It's a good character.
He's a good character.